This is an instructional video to show how to operate the pneumatic door skin tool with optimum results every time. The tool is very user-friendly, is being used successfully by everyone from the professionals at Toyota training facilities to new students at trade schools just learning new collision techniques. By following the simple steps in this video, you'll have great results the first time with no arm stress. Always wear eye protection when operating this tool. First, secure the door so it doesn't move around or have a chance to fall. You can use bungee cords or the killer tool's door stabilizer, as pictured. Once the door is secure, position the door skin on the frame. Use vice grips to clamp the top of the door to the frame and fold the corners over at the bottom. This will ensure that the skin doesn't shift while you're working on it. When you begin the first step, you need to choose the setting or notch in the center of the shaft that works best for the door skin that you're working on. The height of the lip on the door skins vary with makes and models. Therefore, pick the shaft setting that will allow the center of the chisel to hit the top edge of the door skin. You'll know it's correct if the rubber dolly is firm on the door skin and the guide pins are 90 degrees to the frame, and the chisel head is resting on the top edge of the door skin lip. If you find a particular vehicle model that does not conform to the settings provided, make a new cut that will give you the correct starting position. Use the correct air pressure. Because the gauge of metal varies according to make and model, use the air valve on the air hammer to control the air flow. Start at no more than 1/4 turn. It should take 4 to 6 passes minimum to bend the metal. Any less and the air is too high and you may damage the door skin. Spray a light lubricant on the rubber dolly or door skin. Use something that has no silicone and will not harm the rubber dolly, such as Killer Tools KT Lube. While using the door skin, hold the rubber dolly firmly against the door skin while maintaining the guide pins 90 degrees to the frame at all times. Do not roll it forward or roll it back. This decreases the surface area of the rubber dolly protecting the door skin and has the chisel hitting the door skin edge at the wrong angle. Keeping the guide pins 90 degrees to the door frame will ensure that the maximum amount of rubber dolly surface is protecting the door skin. Bend the door skin lip one section at a time in 2 steps. The first step is to bend the door skin edge over between 45 and 60 degrees. Once that is completed, change the shaft setting to the second notch from the top and continue crimping the skin until you've achieved the desired tightness. Keep the tool moving at all times, going over body line smoothly, always 90 degrees to the frame. It is better to do more passes than to increase air pressure. The final result will be a beautiful job with no damage. There are many benefits to this tool other than speed. It doesn't take a journeyman to operate the tool and get good results. There's no fatigue or sore arms after the job. You'll find there are less hammer marks in the door skin lip to remove or cover, and no bondo on the door skin means less material used and a better job. Even the painter will save on prep time and material. Not only will you be able to do door skins with fantastic results, but you'll also be able to fold the lip on the wheel wells of PT Cruisers, Volkswagen Beetles, Audis, and others, all without any arm stress or damage to the vehicle.